foundation that you want to build pretty securely. A binomial. Yeah, I'll try that. Or binomials, it's also in the dictionary of binomials. Binomial time, the first thing we have to know is what is a binomial? Well, let's just talk this, maybe this will be a clue. We have what's called a monomial. We have a binomial. And we have a trinomial. And just like with bicycles, tricycles, and we don't call it a monocycle, we call it a unicycle. It means the same basic gist. A monomial is just a one-term thing. A binomial is a two-term thing. And a trinomial is a three-term thing. We are focusing on this one today. And while binomials can look any way you want, I mean, it could be 3x squared plus x, that's a binomial. We are looking at certain type of binomial today, and that is the binomial that just has a letter and a number. I'm sorry, like b is a number. X plus 3, that's a binomial. Or maybe it's x minus 8. We're just going to look specifically at these types of binomials, two-term things. Because what we're going to do, children, is we're going to take those binomials and multiply them together. What do I get if I multiply it? Well, let's do x plus 3 and multiply it by x plus 2. Doesn't that sound exciting? Now, this is my first time venturing into this world here. I'm going to do it a little differently than I usually do. What did I say? X plus 3 and x plus 2, right? Let's make a visual of this in some sort of a square slash rectangular view. See if this makes any sense to you. If I were drawing this out as a rectangle, and I have x times x, here is what I can make it look like. Let's say this is side x and x is only this big, right? Same thing over here, x is this big. I'm taking x, and I'm adding, I guess I'll add 2 right here, and I'll add 3 right here to it. X plus something, x plus 2 there, x plus 3 there, and I'm going to make a rectangle out of it. And this is my x plus 2 part, this is my x plus 3 part. What do I get if I multiply all that together? Well, what is x times x, this little chunk right here. What do you get when you multiply x times x? So this is x squared, I know that. Should I do it a different color? Yeah. What is this little piece, which is 3 times x? 3 times x is? Yeah, look at you kids, you're so smart. This piece here is 2 times x, which is 2x. And this little chunk right here is, what is it? It's 2 here and it is 3 here, so it is 6. Now, take a look here. If I put all those together and I add all those areas together, I can only add a couple of them because there's only a couple like terms there. There is another x term, x squared terms there, so I'm left with just keeping that x squared. I have a 3x here and a 2x there. I can put those together. 3x's plus 2x's is 5x's, and I just have a little 6 stuck out there, so I go 6 there. This is what you get when you multiply these two binomials together. X squared plus 5x plus 6. We'll do one more of those, and then you'll say, why did you do that again? Well, let's do a minus one. Let's do x plus, well, I can't do minus one. I suppose I could. Let's try with minus. If you're watching this at home, please forget I even did this. X minus 3. But I can't really put the minuses there because I have to, well, we'll do it the same way. Same way. We've got our x plus 4. Here's my x plus my 4. And then I've got my x. You'd think minus 3 would come back, but we'll just make a minus 3 up here. Because it doesn't matter for this sketched out thing. There's my pieces of a pie. What do I get for the x times x? Very good, whoever said x squared but was afraid to say that one. What do I get when I multiply the minus 3 times the x? What do I get when I multiply the 4 times the x?
4x.
And what do I get when I multiply the negative 3 times the 4?
Negative 12.
And once again, you'll realize that, as in all pretty much all the ones we're going to do here, these two corner pieces are always going to be able to be put together. So you end up with x squared. What's a minus 3x plus 4x? X, thank you again for whoever was thinking but didn't want to say, and then you got the minus 12. How about that? Is that relatively exciting? Which, by the way, you don't need to get off track because that usually means that's homework, but I'm going to do this anyways. I can do this with any kind of multiplication. If I had 12 times 15. Check this out. I can do, separating the tens and the fives, I can make this part of my rectangle 10, right? Plus 2 is 12, right? And then I can make this part of my rectangle 10 plus 5 for 15, right? Yes, Mr. Hammond, I can do that. And do all this same multiplication and get the same answer I get when I multiply, because doing the tens, 10 times 10 is 100, 10 times 2 is 20, 5 times 10 is 50, and what's this part here? 2 times 5 is 10. Add all those pieces together, I end up with
180.
If I were to multiply 15 times 12, do I get 180? How about that? Isn't that special?
Yes.
That might help you on some maths tests, because that might come up. Now, back to my binomial thing. Let's say I've got this, x plus 6 times x plus 5. Do you really, really, really want to draw all those squares every time you come up with a problem like that?
Yeah.
No, sir. And because you don't want to do that, there's a little, I mean, it's, I can tell you, you can do this in your head. The answer to this is what? X squared plus 11x plus 30. Okay, that's the answer to that. And it's easy because you have to think about it like this. When you multiply a binomial times a binomial, okay, think about this little anacronym. Is that what they're called?
Anacronym.
Is it an acronym?
Yeah.
Anacronym. A-N, acronym. Think of this little anacronym.
Oh,
that doesn't make sense that way. FOIL. As in rats foiled again. Okay. And when you think of that little anacronym, put a little box around these two. And what these things, what this means is this. F stands for the first terms. O stands for the outside terms. I stands for the inside terms. And the L stands for the last terms. Because what you'll find is this. If you follow this pattern, you can do this pretty easily. What are the two first terms? X times x is
x.
That's where my x squared comes from. What are my two, when I multiply these, my outside term is x. These are the two outside ones. What do I get when I multiply them together? 5x, right? My two inside terms are right here. What do I get when I multiply 6 times x, 6x? And then my two last terms are 6 and 5, and that is 5, 6 times 5 is 30. And the reason I had you put a little box around the O and the I is because in these binomials, your two middle terms, the two things in the middle, will always combine. As long as it looks like this. There'll be other ones where they won't, but this one. For right now, they do. And you can put those two together. What's 5x plus 6x? 11x plus 30. And you have the x squared. Now, you could draw the boxes, but I can guarantee you, if you draw the little box, it's all going to look like that. Okay? So let me give you another one. How about x minus 3? How about x minus 3 times, let's do two minuses, x minus 4. Again, thinking about FOIL. It is my hope that you'll be able to almost do this without really writing much down with this. The first term is going to be x squared. The second term in your answer is going to be the combination of the outside and the inside. The outsides is a negative 4 times x, which is a negative 4x, and the insides is a negative 3 times x, which is a negative 3x. If you put negative 4x and negative 3x together, talking with Vasper Smith, I get what? All right, here in slow motion. My second term of my answer, if I am doing FOIL, I just did the letter F right there. These outside and inside terms, when I multiply them together, will be able to be combined. The outside ones, negative 4 times x is negative 4. The inside, negative 3 times x is negative 3. You'll be able to put them together. Negative 4x, negative 3x is negative 7x's. And then my last term is gets what I multiply the two ending terms together. Negative 3 times negative 4 is positive 12. And this, ladies and gentlemen, is your trinomial answer when you multiply two binomials like that. Now, this only works, again, let me reiterate, when it is a letter and a number, letter, number. Because you can make all sorts of different, I mean, I could, this is a binomial. And I can multiply that by x to the fifth plus 2. If you multiply those two binomials together, this doesn't work. You get a whole bunch of terms. It doesn't work. It only works when you have x's number, whatever it is. So just, but that's all they're going to give you. I just want you to make sure. How about this? Let's you try this one. Let me see how hard they give you. They give you any harder ones? No, not so much. X plus 3 times x minus 5. Should be done with the bell. You can always say your ass spoiled again. Or you can draw the box again. I do like the box. It does make a little bit more. Oh, you look like on YouTube, I'm sure. Just Grace says
x squared plus 8x.
You're missing about, you're going to get a trinomial. You're missing the last term and your middle term is by right. Sammy?
X squared minus 2x is
I believe that would be it. Now here we go, walking through it again.
Yeah.
Smith, we're moving here. Two middles are gonna get combined. My first term, what do I get when I multiply the two first things together? X squared. Everybody's good with that? My middle, single middle term is gonna get when I combine these two outside and the inside. The outside here is negative 5 times x is a negative 5x. The inside here is a positive 3x. Negative 5x, I have 3x's, I take 5 of them away, I'm gonna be minus 2x's. And then your last term comes from the two last things. Negative 5 times positive 3 is a negative 15. The beauty of this, children, is in not so very long, they're going to give you the trinomial and have you work your way back to figure out what two numbers multiplied together gave you that way. That's when things get exciting. Now, here's something else they'll do. How about this? They will say x plus 8, and they'll do this, and they'll put a... And they will put a squared up here. Now I need all of you to look up here so I can tell you I told you so when you make this mistake. Is everybody looking at this? 90% of people when they look at that go, oh, the answer is x squared plus 64. It is not. Okay, when you run across this, what you have to do is say, oh, it's this plus this squared, so you have to write it like that. 8, or x plus 8 times x plus 8. And I guarantee you, when you do this with FOIL, you will get an x squared and you will get a 64, but you'll be missing something in the middle. Because if you do FOIL with this, you're going to end up with the dramatic pause. F-O-I-L. Any children have medical, dental, or vision forms in your backpacks or lockers that were sent in and need to be in the office? Anybody? And out there in La La Land, Michael is questioning. What did you end up with, Michael? We'll see.
I had x squared plus 8x plus 64.
Okay, you're close on that, except for your middle term. The outside and the inside terms. Outside gives you 8x, inside gives you another 8x. Putting those together, it should be 16x. X squared plus 16x plus 64. Or how about this one? Let's go with x minus 1 squared. What would x minus 1 squared be?
X squared minus 2x
plus 1. Your two outside terms are negative 1 and negative 1. Doing it slowly. Again, x squared, that means that times that. Doing FOIL. The first two terms are x and x, so it's x squared. These two are going to get combined. The outside is a negative 1x. The inside is a negative 1x. You're combining them. You're adding them. If I have, oh, somebody an x, I owe another x, I owe them 2x. And your last term is negative 1 times negative 1, which gives you a positive 1. Tell me that does not look like some sort of inertia.
Oh, I see it.
Yeah.
And the mouth.
Looks like a grandma. It looks like Grandma Gertrude does.
It looks like how.
Okay. Okay, and they might give you something like this. What's the area of a square that's I guess it is going.
Why?
I did tell him, just so you know.
I know, but I made a mistake telling you when the appointment was not when you needed to make the patient.
Well, I told him he needed his dad was coming at 10:15, but are you coming back?
I don't know.
No, I don't know what to do just yet, but we'll figure it out. How about do the practice part on that?
Whose side is x plus 6 long? If they ask you that, what is the area of that square going to be? Well, you know by whatever that a square has equal sides, so it would be x plus 6 times x plus 6, so it's a binomial times a binomial, which would give you. Yeah, don't try to do it. Like I said, my goal is that you can do that pretty much without a whole lot of work and effort.
Yeah.
You probably should write it down. X plus 6 times x plus 6 using the whole foil, panoil thing. First, outside, inside, last. Evan thinks he's got it. It is
x squared plus 12x plus 36.
Correct.
First, outside, inside, last.